There's hundreds of different ways to measure different businesses. There's no doubt about it. We're just trying to lay down the five core ones for a very simple approach to startups at their foundation. So a lot of early stage founders ask us, what are the metrics that matter for their startup? And after looking at thousands of companies and building a bunch ourselves, it really comes down to five core metrics for tech-based startups. The first one is retention. It's the most important metric for growing a really big business. This is your main metric for figuring out if you're going to be able to have a really big business or not. A retention just means, does someone stay with the thing, the experience that you're providing with them? Are they coming back for free at all just to use your product, to view it, interact with it, click on a button or two, that sort of thing? That's on one end of the spectrum. And then on sort of business enterprise SaaS, are they paying on a monthly basis for your SaaS product? Do they just keep paying and keep using it? And then in between, there's a whole lot of other stuff like, yeah, they're paying for it, but are they coming back to it and actually using it? If they're using it, how often are they using it? If they're using it often, how much data are they putting in around the thing they're using it for? There's many ways to look at what retention means, but there's the spectrum between free and for paid, and this is the core thing you're going to be looking at. So when you think about retention, you look at your product and you think, what retention do I want in my users? And then I'm going to track it. And you do that with triangle charts, cohort analyses. Okay, you'd see of the people who came in January, how many of them are still using it 6 months later, 12 months later. Within retention, there's going to be the sense of frequency. The frequency in some businesses is very low, and the frequency in other businesses is extremely high, and there's a whole spectrum. For your business, you need to figure out what frequency you want people to be using it at. You don't maybe want them using it every day. Maybe you do. But you have to decide what you think the ideal customer would do from a retention and a frequency perspective, and then aim toward that with your design of the product. The other concept we talk about with retention is the concept of churn, which is really the idea is if someone is paying for a product on a monthly basis, do they churn out of your business and they stop paying? Okay. And so when you're talking to venture capitalists, when you're thinking about the health of your business, you really want to track your churn rates. I finally got someone to try the product. I finally got someone to convert and pay for the product, but now they stopped paying for it. This is a leaky bucket. We're in trouble. So the second core metric is growth rate. Can you get your startup to grow quickly? There's many types of ways of growing. One of them, of course, is paid. We're all familiar with buying ads on Google or elsewhere to drive people to your product so that they can trial it, potentially convert, and go on to retain on your business. But very quickly, you want to get off of paid acquisition if possible. With organic acquisition, you don't have to pay as much to bring people in so that all the profits that you get from a customer accrue to the business. So the hallmark of the very best businesses in the world are that they grow through organic acquisition. Now, this can come through word of mouth, just people talking about you. It can come through PR, people who are in positions of power talking about you and making videos about you and spreading the word, the influencers, the journalists. It could come through SEO. Maybe Google is sending a lot of traffic to all of your web pages, and it just comes through Google for free without you having to pay any SEM, search engine marketing, in order to drive people to your website. It also takes place through K-factor, which is viral engineering, which is not network effects. It's viral engineering or viral effects where you figured out how to get your existing users to bring you more users for free. That's the basic idea of viral engineering. And we measure that through what we call the K-factor. So the K-factor is a metric we use to measure virality. And you can actually engineer this in many of your products by changing the language, by changing the flow. And what you measure is, of the people who came into your product, how many more free users did they get for you over time? Of the people I got in my cohort, how many more free users did they bring me? But viral engineering is still possible, and having a K-factor is still something you're going to want to see in your startup. It might be 0.1, it might be 0.2, but hey, that's better than zero. So in terms of growth, it's interesting to know what the benchmarks could be. And so at an early stage seed fund like ours, if we see that you've got a growth rate of, let's say, 10% a month, we probably won't take the meeting. At 20%, we might. At 30%, I'd probably take the meeting. At 50%, I'd be excited for the meeting. And at 80 to 100%, then I would definitely be excited. I would clear my schedule and make sure that I got to you today. You want to track these metrics because it's going to give you a sense of the health of your business and the potential of your business, right? And if you're not on a high potential track, you want to move to a place where there's more high potential. So you in particular want to track these metrics. Okay, so moving on to number three, CAC, customer acquisition cost. It's basically looking at how much does it cost you to bring in a new customer. Pretty simple, but it's not simple to measure. In fact, it can be difficult, so you have to be pretty careful on this. For most people, CAC is when you've brought a customer in and they've become a paying user. They are a paying customer, and that is what they define as CAC, typically. You're looking for a highly scalable channel with a low CAC, right? And a lot of businesses, particularly in the fintech area, that's all you really care about. Like the whole business is stacked on top of, do you have a highly scalable channel that has low CAC, okay? The second thing you're looking at is fully loaded cost. So a lot of people say, well, I spent $10 on ads on Facebook to acquire customers, so my CAC is $10. Well, that may or may not be true because you might have had to give them a coupon in order to get them to convert. Or you might have had to pay four people on your staff to talk to them on the phone after they came onto your website and gave you their phone number. And so you have to look at the fully loaded costs to bring a person to the point where you can convert them to a paying user or a lifetime user. So the fourth metric is conversion. And you know, they come into your product, you need to activate them so that they understand what the glory of your product is, why they would want it. You need to activate them in some way, and measuring that can be helpful. But ultimately, that activation leads to conversion and retention. So the conversion number is a number that you need to measure very carefully to see if you're going to monetize and keep those people that you've spent all this time and effort bringing in. And on conversion, one side note about marketplaces in particular. You have to have at least two sides of your marketplace, and they need to be there at the same time so that you can have a conversion, a liquidity rate. What do we call in marketplace? We call it liquidity. And an investor or an employee or somebody might ask you about your liquidity rate. And really what they're saying is, if I've listed an item, what percentages of those convert to a sale from the demand side? Okay, and vice versa. If I come from the demand side, what percentage of the time do I find something that I want to buy and then make a transaction? And so those are two different conversion rates that as a marketplace, you need to measure both of those. And together, we call that the liquidity rate of your marketplace. And so that's very specific to marketplaces, but that concept can be useful for a lot of different businesses. So the fifth core metric is LTV or lifetime value. That's really just a measurement of how much money you're going to make from a customer over the lifetime of their usage of your product. Okay, and you're going to have several measurements within that to understand your LTV. One of them is AOV, which is your average order value. And in a case like Airbnb, your average order value might be three nights times $300 whenever you make a purchase there. And that's going to be $900 AOV, and then they're going to make 10% of that. So they make $90. And if you do that four times a year, for Airbnb, they're going to make $360 a year net revenue off of you. And if you use it for 10 years, they're going to make $3,600 off you. So your LTV, let's say for Airbnb, might be $3,600. It's a pretty good LTV. Now, along with this idea of lifetime value comes this idea of CAC to LTV ratio. So if you are spending your CAC of, let's say, $10 to acquire a customer, let's say someone's with you for $20 a month for 4 months, that's $80 lifetime value, and you've only paid $10 for them, your LTV to CAC ratio is now 8, which is really quite good. Right? You're looking for CAC to LTV ratios of 3.5 and above, LTV to CAC ratios of 3.5 and above, to have a reasonable a business. And when calculating LTV, let me be clear, it's not about the total revenue that a consumer might or a customer might be spending on your business. You have to look at what the profit margin is on that. Don't get into this failure mode of thinking that it's the whole amount. Okay, that's just not an accurate way, because what you're looking at is how many dollars come back into your business to pay salaries and to keep the lights on. That's what you really need to understand to see how that mechanism goes between money going out to acquire new users, money coming back in from people paying for something, and then you using that to grow the business. Again, different businesses have different benchmarks about what's great for them, but typically, if we're seeing an LTV to CAC ratio of 3.5 or more, we'll take a look at the business. If it's below that, it's probably not a great business. I should also mention that there might be a more powerful metric around LTV to CAC ratio, which is payback period. Because if you can get a payback period down to 15 days or 30 days or 60 days, that means you can take that money and plow it back into growing the business and adding new users to your business. So we as investors often really look at the payback period, not just the LTV to CAC ratio. You want to have a culture at your startup that believes in data, that looks at the metrics all the time. And that starts at the top. The CEO and the VPs need to be the people who watch these numbers, who measure these numbers, who make sure they're measured accurately, and who talk about them in group meetings, who talk about them in their emails. There's a big gap between founders who understand their metrics and speak in metrics and have them off the top of their head, which you should be, and founders who don't quite know or have to get back to me or that sort of thing. So having an understanding about the KPIs, the key performance indicators, and how far you can go, what those benchmarks are, either from competitors or from people in other industries that have similar types of businesses to yours, is a really critical factor in making your company move really quickly. And that takes research, it takes competitive analysis, it takes talking to a lot of people in your industry to find out what those KPIs should be, and then bringing those back into your organization, making them visual, you know, putting them on the dashboards, putting them on the graphs, putting them on the board, and letting people see them so that they can aim for them. That really moves the needle.